And welcome to the 5th annual Croton Hill Challenge. We are on top of Croton Hill this morning for this lovely sunny day. As you can see, everybody is here behind me getting ready to set up and start our first race of the day, the 5K. Well, how are you today?
I don't know.
And what's your name?
Michael Lynch.
Michael, and who are you doing the run for today?
Crumlin Hospital.
What are you doing here today?
I'm representing the Rotunda Hospital, running amok through the countryside with a share of Vikings chasing me.
Congratulations, that sounds like fun.
Sure, I'm a bit of a lunatic, what can I say?
Well, what's your name?
Joe Heffernan.
Joe, are you doing the race today?
Yes.
Have you trained much for us?
Not that much, but I think once.
All smiles and laughter as the 800 participants embark on the Croton Hill Challenge 5K course. The course starts with a ski jump, tiger trap, and loop down to the Sherard Forest, giving the competitors a 1 kilometer uphill climb through bullfinches and coffin complexes, before bringing them to the apex of the course, to the Conlon water slide, where the participants will get their first panoramic view of the course. This is where they will have a nice dip in the pool. Among the charities that are using this event as a fundraiser are Crumlin's Children's Hospital, Little Wishes, Diabetes Ireland, and the Rotunda Hospital, to name but a few, along with the hen parties and our own local Anya Mulligan. Gerard Omron running for the Aura Sports Complex of Tullamore, raising plenty of money for Diabetes Ireland. Gordon Kerrigan from Road, followed by the Gorman brothers, along with 40 other Aurum members who trained at the fantastic sports complex in Tullamore to raise money for Diabetes Ireland. Jake Marr from Eden Derry, David Lynham and David Smith showing how to ride the slide in style. Sharon Courtney from Dublin is a little bit apprehensive tackling this obstacle.
Is it nice in there?
Lovely.
Are you cold?
I should have brought my armbands.
Come on, yourself. What age are you?
10.
How are you getting on with the race? One of the first ladies out in front. What's your name?
Ruth Robinson.
How are you finding it, Ruth?
Great crack.
The participants descend along the Great Wall via the Machu Picchu steps to go through the Bogman crawl and then back up to the infamous Sheep Dipper. Here in the blue shorts are some of the 250 Crumlin Hospital fundraisers who've brought a bus full of people from as far away as Gorey, Ockram, Wicklow, Tipperary and even Derry. Michael Brennan and Michael Lynch from Dangan, followed by more locals trying to earn some much needed funds. The fundraiser was spearheaded by Anthony and Sheila Foy, Aisling Wine, Peter Moore, Trish and Bill Quigley, to name but a few. The target was set for €10,000, but that was smashed to what looks more like in excess of €25,000 for Crumlin Children's Hospital. Roisin Dean, followed by Sarah and Jack Kehoe, taking the flow complex at ease. Sean Egan and Brian McCormack, our local stewards, supervising the safe crossing at and Muntbath, for Sharon, Victoria, and Charlie Conroy of Road. Susan Howard of Galway successfully manages to cross Anne's Mudbath, as the group of Melanie Rivers, Aisling Curley from New York, Priscilla Coombe, Donna Mooney, and Carol Leonard make their hesitant attempts, some not as lucky as others. Some of the young competitors seem more like George at the Jungle rather than Tarzan.
Can you tell us a bit about your charity?
It's for Diabetes Ireland, from the Leisure Centre or Tullamore. We're doing it for, there's about 40 of us doing it for Diabetes Ireland.
Congratulations, I'm sure we'll see you along the route. Yes.
Thank you.
Best of luck.
The contestants are slowly wading their way through the canal lock now. Another large group from Crumlin, led by our local Aaron Kennedy. Some going under, some going over, and some just here to give their hair a wash. We are reaching the midpoint of the race now. Paul McGivney, followed by Rachel Dalton, having no problem through the Stonehenge complex. John Cocoman helping Deirdre Egan through the spider web. Colette Brackett wisely removing her helmet for those tricky nets. Ruth Robinson here might be more comfortable doing this course on horseback. Some of the younger competitors at home in the Sheep Dipper, showing the adults how it's done. One of the stronger runners here seemed to be relieved to be out of the Sheep Dipper.
Is it cold in there?
Oh, it's grand. You want to come in and
No, I'm good, thanks.
Oh, come on.
Where are all ye from?
Rhodes.
Rhodes. And what age are you?
11.
And what's your name?
Kira.
You having a good day, Kira?
Yeah.
I like your sparkly shoes.
Thank you. Yeah.
And what age are you?
10.
Good boy. What's your name?
Sean.
Good man, Sean. Hello in there.
Hello.
Oh, here comes somebody.
Yes.
What's your name?
Katrina.
What's it like in there, Katrina?
Very enclosed. Me no like it.
I don't think me no like it either.
Total gridlock here at Bondi Bridge. Some of our more nervous participants, like John Joyce, showing us a very conservative approach. Our brave Vikings are taking a more adventurous approach, showing us how it should be done. Carol Foy is coming out of Lorna's Water Complex, followed by members of the Aura team, supporting Diabetes Ireland. While the Braveheart, Sharon Victoria, is having no problems with the Quincy Slide. Bernie from Crumlin, there's no point in closing your eyes. Ella Kennedy and her friend having no problems in the Sherwood Forest. Our stewards Patsy Eakin and Robert Bagnall are having some difficulty to control the antics of John Scally, Owen Lawler and local priest Father Greg Corcoran, all of whom are running for Crumlin Children's Hospital. Michael Scott from Donegal will now be known as the Bullet. He is followed by an over-enthusiastic comrade. Some of the younger contestants here find the Quincy Slide just a little bit more daunting.
Hello, what's your name?
Emma.
Emma, where are you from?
Mood.
And are you doing it for a charity today, Emma?
Yeah, Irish Cancer Society.
Wow, and is there many of you doing it?
Yeah, a good few. There's one stuck in the tunnel somewhere.
The tunnel that you opted out of?
Yeah.
You afraid of the dark?
Yeah.
Now, one thing that struck me about you is your famous shoes. Her shoes have toes in them. We're here at the Bone Shaker, what it's called, and there everybody's going to slide down here and is that big pile of muck at the bottom.
Great composure here by Nicola Davidson and Lane Cooney as they descend full speed down the 125-foot Bone Shaker slide. This vent is aptly called the Bone Shaker, as it does exactly what it says on the tin, shakes every bone in your body. Sharon, Victoria and Bernard Ward adopting the popular bobsled approach on the Bone Shaker. Our head steward, Jared Nolan, better known as the Grubber, was flat out retrieving participants from the peat. He shouldn't complain, as he actually constructed this obstacle.
Jared's here today, digging everybody out of all this muck. You all right?
Claudia Musial has been rescued from the peat trap at the bottom of the Bone Shaker by Gerard. Steffi Heffernan of the Road Playground Project looks on in amusement. The Road Playground Project, who used this event as a fundraiser last year, turned their first sod this month.
Hello.
Hello.
What's your name?
Joe the Red.
Joe the Red.
Red.
Joe, you're
one
looking...
One of the most famous Vikings of all times.
Oh, you're actually named after a Viking as well.
Yeah.
We're at the old Crohan Bogman, which takes its name from the ancient body found in the bog of Crohan. Some of the stragglers here are still going strong as they make their way slowly and surely towards the Bone Shaker.
You look like you're stopping for a rest.
Hang on a minute, I'm just doing an interview here.
Are you okay in there?
I think I'm okay. They want me for the telly.
You're the girls from Amman.
Little Wishes.
Little Wishes. And where do you all come from?
Eden Derry.
Eden Derry, and what's your charity for?
Trina can explain.
It's a local comfort fund for people with cancer.
Very good. Now, can you do your dance? I see you're trying to keep warm there. Now, can you show everybody at home your little dance to keep warm? So they'll all know for next year when they come and join us.
Back at the Bone Shaker, this now famous slide was stewarded by Mary Wright. To the delight of David, his father, local AIB manager, Miles Gillespie, and his brother, Craig, who got buried alive at the Bone Shaker.
As you can see, folks, we're having a wild day here at the Croton Hill Challenge. We're covered in muck from head to toe, quite literally. Join us in part two for more thrills, spills and adventures here on Croton Hill at the Croton Hill Challenge.
Okay, guys. Ready, 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 ready,
Foy. Hi Anthony.
Hi Shauna, how are you?
And Frankie Rice.
Shauna, how you doing?
Not too bad. How are you finding today?
Well, it was a huge success. We had massive crowds, delighted. We went with a Viking team with the whole occasion today. It's part of the gathering, which we invited the Vikings, as our ancestors as far back as the Vikings were invited to the gathering. So we kind of tied in with that team, so we decided to break a world record while we were doing it. That's where our attempt before the two races today was to get as many people here dressed as Vikings and record the attempt. Well, 250 is what we had to beat. We were estimating 600-700 people to run in the 5K. We said if we got half of them to come dressed up, we would get around 300 Vikings. So I'd be happy with 300.
Now, Frankie, are you going to reveal to us whether we beat that now or not?
I am.
And make this man's long weekend.
Unfortunately, Anthony, I have to tell you, you didn't get 300.
What did we get?
You got... I have it here.
Here it is, drum roll.
Hey! 371.
Hey, congratulations, 371. You were here last year.
I was indeed.
And what happened last year?
Oh, it was just brilliant crack, brilliant fun.
But you won.
Oh, I won last year, that's right.
You won the 10K.
That's right, won the 10K last
You're
year.
You're the Dangan Harriers.
Tullamore Harriers.
Oh, Tullamore Harriers. I have a really good memory.
Yeah, very good.
What's your name again, Sam?
Jody O'Reilly.
Jody O'Reilly. And do you think you'll win it again this year?
I hope so. Yeah.
We're about to take off here at the 10K, the Croton Hill Challenge. And they're off.
Welcome back to the Croton Hill 10K race. The 10-kilometre run consists of two laps of the 5K course. The competitors will luckily get to enjoy each obstacle twice. Neil Kazer from Dublin, Michael Bean from Clara, County Offaly, are both strong contenders at the Conlon slide for the 10K. Rory from Swords and a local competitor, who is now a very successful runner after taking up the sport later in life. Amantis from RD, County Louth, crawling out of the bogman in Viking style. Jonathan and Roger McDonough from Rosgrey, County Galway, approaching Anne's Mud Bath with ease. There is no need for the ropes for these men. Di McShiva from Dublin, keeping ahead of Dean Galvin of the Aura team. Dean is also one of the main organisers of the 40 people who came here to fundraise for Diabetes Ireland.
We're here with Greg Starr, and Greg was on Operation Transformation this year and has lost a total of?
So far, I've just under 4 stone gone. It was 2 stone 11 during the show, and I've lost another stone a bit since. So.
Congratulations, Greg. That's a massive achievement. And Greg, have you done this course before?
No, I've never done this course before. I've never been here before. It's a fantastic course. It's tough.
Greg is actually cleaned up from what he was looking like earlier on, just so you know.
Yeah, I've been showered and changed and everything now at this stage. But it's a fantastic course. It's nearly as tough as the Curragh with Sergeant Mull during the winter. But very, very tough. Tough on the knees, but great fun. Absolutely great fun. Great crack.
Would you advise people now to come and do it and participate?
I would more than advise it. It's one of the best events I've ever done. It's better than any 10K run. It's better than anything. It's great. It's great fun. It's a full body workout.
Louise Welby from Craigs Galway making her way into the Carrick Rope Bridge after going through the spooky tunnel. The spooky tunnel is 50 foot of complete darkness. Not advised to the claustrophobic. Viking Joe the Red keeping a watchful eye on all the competitors. No cheating in his territory. Jimmy Breen from Clonaski, County Leash, and his friends doing their best to soak the photographers, using the right angle approach for the maximum speed and impact. Followed by a very hesitant competitor who seems to regret taking on the Quincy slide.
Hello. What? You've no makeup on.
Paul.
And where are you from, Paul?
Kilcullen.
You having a good day?
Originally.
Good day.
Savage day. No, first time.
Best of luck.
Eddie Kelleher and Ray Dunn from Edenderry making their way smoothly across the Bondi Bridge. Amantis could have completed the course blindfolded by the looks of things. He goes through the lock canal with precision and ease.
We're here with Peter Moore, chief organiser of this event here today. Now, Peter, how long has it taken you to actually prepare for this event?
1,000 hours.
1,000 hours, folks, has gone into this.
We started way before Christmas, and I work each night till 9 o'clock.
Peter, the course, did it change much from last year, or is there any improvements you made to it this year?
Yeah, well, there's a big change, because we started here with a track, a 500-metre track, to take in the hills, and we finished with a 500-metre track, do this track in reverse, and we added an extension to it so that when you get to the Conlon slide you deserve a good dip, because it's 1.5 kilometres uphill before you get there. And
I'm sure they've worked up the sweat then, so they need to cool down for a while.
They are relieved. They don't be complaining about the cold water. And we also added a bone shaker and a spooky tunnel.
Well, congratulations, Peter. It's been a fantastic year here. Everybody's enjoyed it. And I'm sure we'll see you again here next year.
Okay. Thank you very much, and thank you for covering the program.
Trish, can you tell us to date how much you've raised?
We have raised to date 5,145, and we have more money coming in.
Congratulations. I think that deserves a round of applause, everybody. Well done. And have you done anything else apart from the Cotton Hill Challenge?
We have done a few car boat sales, which we are raising money for John's Ward's teenagers. And we have done non-uniform day with Ockham National School and Avondale Community College in Rathdrum at Christmas time, and we raised 2,500. We have a few other things in the pipeline as well for Crumlin.
Well, congratulations. You all seem to be doing a very, very good job, and you all should be very proud of yourselves. Well done.
Coming to the end of the event now, we are on the second lap of the 10K. Keith Hogan and his colleagues could definitely do with a case of Red Bull at this stage. The Crumlin party are finishing strongly, clearing the fences as good as a horse. Aisling Mulligan showing some apprehension. Elaine Williams from France and our two friends from Finland actually thumbed from Galway, dressed as Vikings to be here today.
We're here with Gay Lawton, one of the sponsors of the Cotton Hill Challenge today. How are you today, Gay?
Good, thanks.
Did you have a good day?
Great. I didn't do the challenge. I'm tired looking, but it was great. Children all did it.
Oh, did they? How did they find it?
Great. Loved it.
Will they be doing it again next year?
Tomorrow morning.
How did you find today?
Oh, it was fabulous. Such fun. We had such fun.
And where did you travel from?
Limerick, County Mayo.
Oh, congratulations. That was a good owl haul. And did you do it for a charity or just for the fun of it?
Just for the fun.
Anne Mulligan, the daughter of the great Eugene Mulligan, celebrating her hen party with Sarah, Una, Ursula, Deirdre, Kira and Paula. Quincy slide steward Ollie Feary, back with a smile on his face as the Quincy waterfall is operating at full capacity. Michael Manley, Lewis Welby and Paul Wilson are really making the most of the last slide.
Oh, here he comes. Woo! Is it nice in there?
You coming in?
Will you bring in your armbands or rubber duck? Or would you bring in herself?
Oh, she's still in there.
And these are the two ladies who's out in front for the ladies in the 10K. Ladies, I have to say, you're looking fabulous.
Thank you.
You still have makeup still intact. What's your name?
Sharon.
Where are you from, Sharon?
Stroud.
Oh, very good. You came the whole way from Galway.
We did.
Oh, yeah. Is it okay in there?
It's lovely, yeah. That's why I stayed so long.
I was wondering when anybody was going to come out.
It's comfortable.
Is it very dark inside?
Yeah, you can't see anything.
Congratulations, the winner of the 10K at this year's Grattan Hill Challenge. Is this your first time to do it?
Yes.
You do it again next year?
Don't know.
That's a definitely. Congratulations, well done. Have you been training for it?
Running anyway, so cheers.
Well done. Congratulations. Sheila, you're looking very well.
Thank you very much, and I'm feeling very well too.
Were you dressed as a Viking today?
I was, yeah. I'm still half dressed, but not
tough. You're going for the Braveheart look.
Yeah, that sort of thing.
Congratulations. And you're here supporting Crumlin's sick children as well?
That's right, yeah. This all started out because my grandson, who was born 13 weeks ago today, when he was an hour old, he discovered that he had a thing called transposition of the grey arteries, and he needed major open heart surgery. Thank God, thanks to Crumlin and to the magical doctors and brilliant nurses there. He's perfect. He's up in my house now and he's smiling at everyone and we just feel so blessed. And for that reason, I would just love to thank everyone who came. As you can see, from Ockham, Gorey, Mayo, Derry.
There's a right crowd here today.
All over Ireland, just supporting Crumlin. And I know that some people here had to have some involvement with Crumlin. But it's a great place, not a nice place to be, but they do great work. Just the bottom of my heart, I'm so grateful.
Challenge 2013. It's been a great day. The sun is shining now and everybody's off for some food and some hot beverages after this wind up here in Crotton Hill. It's been full of thrills, spills, adventures, muck, slides and a lot of sport and fun from people all over the country. So join us here next year on Crotton Hill for the Crotton Hill Challenge.